gender, I will give some more information about who am I and what I'm doing, and then I will talk about it, what kind of projects I be involved, and then the projects and ongoing projects, and then my thesis project ideas, and then questions. This is my twin boys. As I said, I have twin boys, and also I have twin cats. Those are the and this is the just orientation of where Bulgaria is and then Turkey is. And I came from Sparta, this is what the and then I'm Serena Demeros is in Sparta, and I was born in Sparta, just my hometown. And this is a shot from Sparta. And the population is about 300,000.
A little bit bigger than Sparta.
Yes. And the spot is also famous for as Bulgaria, roses. And this is the city where I was born. And this is the university where I am teaching.
Very nice.
It's a big university. This is the east campus, there is also west campus. This is a short forest. And I was graduated from some university, electronic engineering, and also I got my master's degree from electronic engineering from some university. And I work as a research assistant at the University of University between 1995 and 1997. And also I was doing my PhD at this university. When I was preparing my PhD dissertation, I got a scholarship from Turkish government and then went back to the university. And I got another master's and PhD from the University of Florida. This is the University of Florida. And in 2008 and 2009, I went to the United States again for a postdoc and worked at Games Learning and Society Research Group. On mobile media learning research project. This was an interesting experience for me to know more about education games and how to design education games. And also I worked with a team here to develop an ARIS mobile game platform. This is also available online, it's free, you may also download. And I'm still competing with that team. That mobile game platform. In 2013 and 14, I went back to the United States again as a both postdoc and graduate faculty. I taught a course at Digital World Institute. It was about developing startups, and also I worked with professors from special education to develop a game for kids with autism in order to develop their peer-related social interaction skills. And also, I'm trying to. I work at Erasmus Plus project for that mobile application about 2 years ago. I submitted in Turkey as a coordinator, but we got a very good score, but wasn't supported. That's why I'm thinking to submit again. Maybe you may be a coordinator of that project, and that's why I came with the other reason where. I will also keep communicating with in order to develop the proposal. And the project I involved, so far, those are the projects done. The one is implementing learning game resources based on educational content. We developed an educational game for language learning, and then also we trained adult trainers how to use this educational game in their training. And the other one is this mainstream of games in learning courses. This project was about assessing the European Union supported game projects and then how they affect and how are they sustainable support. And we wrote a report for policy makers in this project. The other one is UCREATE project. In this cooperation for innovation and exchange for good practices, in this project we developed how to improve online collaboration among the higher education institutions. We also gave courses for example, Geneva University and Finland to develop courses. because of a huge project. There were a lot of partners in this project, and I was involved in this project in a small scale, but it was a good experience for me to be in this project. The other one was workshop in a sustainable society. This was a 1 year project. We met in Italy with my ecology students and ecology students all over the world, all over Europe, and then they discussed how to improve like education, unemployment, this kind of problems, and then locally, at the end of the project we brought a report for question. This is an individual project that I worked with my graduate student. It was an online multimedia, digital multimedia initiative. There was a project, there was a program in the University of South Medicine, the program of the World Language Department. We developed an online youth-like environment for the people who want to learn Turkish language. It was a cultural tips. Translations, those were keywords that the guided the questions, slow audio and video subtitles, etc. This was one of our first software program we exported to the US. And this is another project. It was an online classroom simulator, SimSchool. I was a partner of this project. And also during our partnership, we gave some feedback to the developers. It was a huge initiative. And I allow my graduate students to practice their classroom management skills in this online simulator. Now the project's in progress, and one is we learn project. It's almost done. We are the project will be and it will be finished at the end of August. This is this project was about creating cookies, developing cookies to. For intercultural competencies of higher education teachers. Those are the purpose of this project. And ReSport is also a new project. In this project, we are developing a learning portal. We are developing a learning portal and videos and learning activities for y'all, for the people who has special needs, especially y'all. In order to encourage them to participate physical activities. Those are the purpose of this project. And this is IEngage project, engaging with female paid actors to improve women's rights and women's violence against women and girls. We are this project was accepted last year, but we haven't started yet because we are negotiating to increase the budget because of the economic turmoil in Turkey. The euro was twice.
What does it mean, faith actors?
Faith actors, like women faith actors, like preachers and teachers in religious. Okay. Those are the projects that I was working as an advisor. In 2019, those are my kids, and then they have a team. They set up a team. They entered a flying carpet project. They were the number one. They were place number one in Turkey. In that is a flying carpet ceremony. Those are the ceremony from. Okay. In 2021, we also joined another project. This project was invited as a final. Competition, but we didn't get any. This is my Clean Voice project. They are developing education games in Android, and they use those programs, five different programs, to develop the game, but we didn't get any set up. But in this project, this is my graduate project. This project is about teaching kids with autism. For to teach them how to on traffic rules or how to go across the street. There were more than 30,000 projects. These placed number fourth in Turkey in this there was a two-day project competition that was in this project, and I was also advisor of this project. And then it was about a game to teach history, the work in Darfur. This project was placed number one in Turkey as a software project. Those are my invoice project, let's say. And then you got the ceremony in Turkey. Yes. The ceremony was in Trabzon, in Turkey. Now, my future plan, project ideas. One is developing gamified teaching methods and methods for AI teaching. AI, you know, is our everyday life and it's getting much bigger, growing in industry every day. So, but there are almost two materials and teaching curriculum in both middle school and high school. That's why what I'm thinking in this project idea to develop curriculum materials for teachers to explain them how AI works in order to understand in order to prepare them for our daily life, because everything is powered by AI in our daily life, from the smartphones and the washing machine. To create innovative pedagogical approaches utilizing ICT tools or gamification tools, to have students to better understand how AI works, and also to improve understanding of AI related ethics and challenges, because AI comes with problems of safety, like ethics problems and other kind of problems that you should teach them how to manage or how to understand these problems. That's another one. This was, we were discussing with a professor from medical school to develop an augmented reality application as a supplementary tool for teaching acute coronary syndrome. It was a kind of a software project to teach cardiac respiratory oxygen, addressing multiple senses with augmented reality. We were planning to develop a two different applications, one for patients and one for the professors at the medical school to teach them to use this kind of application to teach their students, and also for the patients when they were waiting, like being blind, and then learn more about cardiovascular problems and etc. The other one was to create a virtual training game for cybersecurity and data protection. This is another project idea. We were also planning to collaborate with cyber training company, but last year I was very busy, and then pandemics comes, and that's like it's only in line that I'm planning to do. This is the project that I submitted about 2 years ago. That's why I'm planning to submit again to develop and design and develop an interactive digital narratives and scenarios and mobile games to enhance the peer-related social skills of students with autism. To develop innovative digital narratives first, then when mass develops most with innovative narratives, then we are gonna let them play a game to reinforce their social skills through the game-based interventions. Those are the ideas and projects.
Well, thank you. It was very impressive.
So that's why I'm here.
I will repeat my